Hello and welcome to our short guide to smart contract automation. The first thing about smart contracts, they're not really that smart. The code will only execute when a certain condition is met. For example, a button click that triggers an event like a transaction. But what if you need your smart contract to be smarter and execute independently? Maybe you want to automatically reinvest your token earnings, set up automatic DAO salary payouts, or even rent out NFTs. What then? That's where Gelato comes in. As Web3's decentralized backend, they empower builders to create augmented smart contracts that are automated, gasless, and off-chain aware. One of the great things about Gelato is that they actually provide a little task that gets you to mint your own NFT using one of their smart contracts. We'll be working with this ice cream NFT contract that has a lick function that, when invoked, licks the ice cream until it gradually disappears, just like the real thing. In a second, we'll take a look at the code for this in GitHub, but for now, I'm going to go ahead and connect my wallet. All right, now let's go ahead and create a task. So this right here is where we would paste the address of our smart contract and then select the lick function from this list here. As you can see, our token ID is 148, so let's just input that and set the interval to every 5 minutes. We'll leave it checked at start immediately so we can see this taking place. Almost done, I promise. I'm just gonna go ahead and confirm the use of some of my test ETH here. I'm gonna call this task Sarah's Gelato, and we're done. Before we celebrate, it's important to note though that we used a predefined input for our token ID. You can also pass dynamic inputs to your resolver, so you can make your function arguments dynamic. Right here, we can see our lick function that we just named. If we click on this, we'll be able to track the information related to this function execution. Now, really quickly, let's look at this contract in GitHub. This is a standard Solidity contract for an NFT, and we know the function we'll be invoking is this lick function. So it's going to require an argument of our own token ID, and then it's going to check that this can only be invoked every 5 minutes, otherwise we're going to get brain freeze and can't lick the cone again. So it checks the block timestamp, and then we'll increment the lick count and record the time. So there you have it. It really is just that easy to set up. Check out the description box for more resources, and we'll see you soon in the next video.